Randy Richardson, Angel Kent, and Tyler Ricks are our officials tonight. Great to have you with us for the WNBA on ION. It's wrestled away by Thomas, tip corralled, and we're underway at Mohegan Sun. Very physical game. Tierra McCowan has fouled out of that game, kicked it out to Dangerfield. The two from the free throw line extended. Howard on the old glass. Ogunbowale for three, knocks it down. Heidemann maneuvers around a pair of screens. Heidemann hangs, finishes.
She was a monster, just crushing them. Did everything she could, but they weren't able to get
Beck,
the W.
Pardon me, AB. Beck Allen, beautiful off-ball cut, has talked about work adjustment for her starting. This is start number 18 in 31 games. This has been the group without Brianna Jones. Potter connects from distance. This is a tough building to play in, folks, including this year, going back now to 2017. Connecticut has won 80% of their home game.
I was going to do the chant, but I didn't do it.
Well, AB, we have, it's a national audience, so if you want to put yourself out there. Bonner speeds ahead for the Sun.
Let's go, Sun!
On the crossover, Bonner blows by Howard, counted and one. Then with four on the shot clock, lost her dribble, somehow got it back on the deflection.
Wow.
And it swirls out! Nelson Adota cleanup crew! Connecticut offensive rebound. And that was a category Dallas dominated in late July. They had 18-0 boards. McCowan freestyle on the block.
Read and react, reacting on offense.
Sabale steps through, right hand. He's gifted as a lefty, McCowan.
That Dallas has.
There's a 3-second differential in the clocks. Heidemann hangs, banks it in.
Think about getting the ball to her and feeding her inside.
Yeah, I know she was upset with last game, how she got fouled out and wasn't able to help us a lot, but she came out dominating this quarter, so she's going to keep that going.
Thanks, Arike.
The last game, because she's being really aggressive, trying to dominate her time in the paint, and really carrying the team right now.
Ogunbowale busy at the free throw line, 7 of 8. Meanwhile, Connecticut 0 for 3 in the game. Bonner on the drive. Now, on this side, they don't get a call.
Inside out. That's a recipe for a victory.
And the lead changes once again. On cue, Arike wants to change the score once more.
Really gave her an opportunity to rest, get some relaxation in, get some additional training in, and be really ready to go for today.
Thomas, oh my! Oh, this would be a fantastic playoff series if these two teams met. Harris the strip. Now Sims and Ogunbowale late to get back. Harris spots up. Got it! Strong, Bonner rips it down. That's happened a second time now. Bonner miscommunicates on the outlet. Howard lays it in with the left hand. That's turned out to be a great timeout by Coach Trammell. Arike for the lead, swirls it in. Eighth lead change of this first half. It's sort of stunning to think, Ashley, that only one team has done that. But if Dallas puts it all together, Carrington breaks free and lays it home. But if Dallas puts it together in a playoff series, Arike is now 4 for 4 from three.
If you're not an aggressive team who can beat them in transition and shoot threes.
Fusion and Carrington on the block. Had some nightmares in this building. Howard on the follow. Grabs another miss and puts it in. Natasha Howard flexes her muscles. Skip past Thomas. Nothing but net. That is exactly what Coach Trammell said. Sabale feeds Howard. That's a classic pick and roll. 80 seconds to play in the first half. This is a 16-6 Dallas run. The spin and the run by Satu Sabale.
The smallest person on the court with the first three offensive rebounds of the second half.
Sabale drains a three.
And just when you're least expecting it, boom, there goes a three.
Largest lead for either team. Dallas by 9. Hayes with the left. What a great welcome for Coach Trammell. Ogunbowale, the fall away baseline jump.
refs on top of that one.
Connecticut, with a loss tonight, would be three straight losses. And they have not lost three straight. Right? Ogunbowale almost knocked down her fifth three. Dangerfield, swiper. Yes, you can swipe. Game difference. That's it between 4 and 8. Chicago is 4 games back of number 4, Dallas, right now. Carrington leapfrogs in the paint. Can find a way to come back and win this game. They'll clinch a playoff berth for a 7th straight year. McCowan on the offensive glass. Carrington, Bonner, Thomas, and Hayes, the 5 on the floor for the Sun. Bonner. Hezzy, right hand, the finish.
Really great job at closing off on DB on her three, and she's been able to really attack. Oh, man. Attack and finish.
Bowala.
Tip was looking for a push-off. I don't know. I don't know if she pushed off or not.
Bonner on the drive, untouched.
Absolutely. She's had a rough go at it, injuries, and just being on teams that couldn't compete.
Each of these teams' last game played was against each other. In the rematch of last year's first round playoff series, Tiffany Hayes. 8 seconds to shoot. Ogunbowale has drilled 5 threes in the game. Slings to Kuir with 3. Ogunbowale got it up in time.
Oh my God.
Arike Ogunbowale. She did earlier this year against Seattle.
She is just a shot maker. I mean, I don't think there's a shot that she can't make.
With 23, Thomas and Hayes have each chipped in 11 points. Dangerfield, the Hezzy squirts right by Thomas.
Right.
There was no words.
Right. All game, though, there's been a lot of throwing the balls in the air, waving, flailing of the hands when a call has been made.
Of Sobley. What a big lineup here for Dallas. Howard, Kuir, and McCowan out there with the two guards, and Dangerfield and Ogunbowale. Heidemann with 2 seconds to shoot is stripped. Meanwhile, Arike Ogunbowale is putting on a show tonight. Howard on the block.
Earlier in the season, they would give up leads. How are they finishing games? Later on in the season, they've been able to close out games. And as you can see, that's what they're trying to do tonight. They would be in games like this. They would give up the lead. Next thing you know, it's 2 points, and they're losing the games. And now you can see the maturity level that they've displayed throughout the season.
ATLA in 13-7-7. The Sun have to hold up their end of the bargain on defense. Dangerfield drills the jumper, plus a foul. Four of the wings, not in double figures. Draws two. Howard loves. Brown with the left hand. Rebound Howard. This is feeling eerily similar to what we saw in Arlington last Saturday. Arike up to 24 points. Combined the last time they met. And now they're at 88. Must score possession for the Sun. There's Thomas.
All night is getting to the spin cycle and scoring in the paint.
Sun over the limit. Ogunbowale untouched. The success of this ball club, especially at home. Ogunbowale, her 7th 3 of the night. That ties a career high. Connecticut cannot buy a basket right now.
B, if I were to tell you that Satu only has 6 points and they have 92 points in the game.
Brown. Throws it up with the right, Leah Brown. Nicely done to halt the run. And for Dallas, they'll improve to 17-14. They'll stay in the 4th spot.